Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to Lightning Gaming. So for this video guys, I got a new exploit. I just discovered it, no one else ever posted it on YouTube, and this is basically gonna give you a invincible horde base. This is so overpowered guys. Please remember to give a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button if you enjoy this content. You'll be the first one to ever see this exploit. It's new, never before posted. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna go to the world border. And then you're gonna go to the first spot, you can place a block. Now guys, what's different from this and the trader is, at the trader, they fixed it, and when you place a block, two blocks closer to the border, you can still mine out. But at the border guys, you can't mine any further than where you can place a block. Like you can see over here, you can only start mining right at the spot where you place the blocks. Which gives you an invincible wall against the world border, and yeah, nothing, zombies can't dig that wall, they can't do anything to that wall. But we're gonna use that, we're gonna build a horde base, and zombies will just jump over you, they can't even get near your base. And I'm gonna show you how to do that right now. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna pick up the blocks you placed and you're gonna start digging right at the spot where the border, where you can place the first block. Now guys, if you go more to the right, you can't dig out any more blocks. To the left, you can dig out. So yeah, you're gonna see what I mean in a couple of seconds. So we're gonna dig down as deep as you can. You can go all the way to bedrock if you want. You can use dynamite to dig it deeper. Cause remember, you can't destroy this wall against the border. So dig it as deep as you can. It will just benefit you. What basically is gonna happen guys, we're gonna have a horde base that zombies can't get to. It's impossible to get to it, and I'm gonna show you right now how to build it. First we need a very deep trench. Now I started it like this and finished it with dynamite so that it looks like this inside. As you can see guys, we have one solid wall and then the other side is a breakable wall. Okay, so now I'm just gonna place some more dynamite on the top to blow the entrance bigger. Because the thing is, you're gonna build a cliff base against a solid wall, the wall that can't be destroyed. So you're gonna want to blow this up as much as you can. Because the wider it is, the more likely it is for zombies to miss you. But in case they do drop on your base, I'm gonna show you how to build it. So that they just basically gonna fall off. Now I'm not even close to halfway to bedrock yet guys, and the base already works. Now if you go all the way to bedrock, it's even gonna be better. So what I'm doing is I'm just blowing it up wider. And yeah, that should be almost good enough. I'm just gonna blow out these so that we have a nice big spot to work in. Okay, so I'm finally ready guys. Here's the hole. This is what it looks like when I'm finished. I'm not even close to bedrock yet. And as you can see, this wall is impenetrable. You can't destroy anything. And this side, you can destroy as you like. Now guys, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna put our base straight up against that world border. And what's the worst of all, the worst exploit is you're gonna be able to place blocks right against this wall. Now imagine that guys, when zombies drop down and they want to come up, they can't do anything. They can't destroy blocks to get to you. They're just gonna basically stand right underneath you and you're gonna be able to shoot them without them being able to do anything. Now first up, what you're gonna do is you're gonna use the wedge 60 tip. You're gonna start your ramp just like this. Now you're gonna go over to the next ramp. Just rotate it right over here for you guys. Go to advanced rotations. Okay, almost there, almost there. There we go. Now you're gonna place this all through. And then you're gonna use the final ramp. And you're gonna place it. Okay, we're just gonna place some solid blocks first guys, so that we at least have a two block space to work in. And as you can see guys, you can just continue placing blocks whichever way you want, but we're gonna use these blocks and we're gonna go a little further. So we're gonna place another solid block right over here. Now what this ramp is gonna do, if they drop on top of your base right from the top, they're just gonna react all down and fall straight to the bottom. This is so amazing guys, I can't believe no one ever saw this. This works perfectly, it never fails. And yeah, I tested it a couple times now. You should go test it on your own game. So what I'm going to do for the floor of the space, I'm just going to use scaffolding so that I'm able to shoot straight through. Remember to keep it under your roof, guys, because you don't want any zombies getting stuck on it. So I'm just going to place it all the way through just like this. Now I know I did use the fly command to do this build. It's only so it's quicker, but ladders or normal construction blocks works just as good. You can do it whichever way you want. Now I'm just putting some half slabs out here. There we go. Let me just finish that up real quick. Okay, I'm just going to fast forward the building part. Okay, so it's finally finished. And you can see you can shoot through the sides and you can shoot through the ground. And yeah, if you take a look at it, guys, it's all against a solid wall which cannot be destroyed. So when zombies drop down, they have no way of getting back at you. And they can't get stuck on top of your base. The only thing they can do is they can dig to the sides, but they'll never be able to get to you. Plus, if demolishers explodes down there, it's only going to be in your benefit because they're going to dig the hole deeper for you. So basically, guys, this is an invincible horde base. There's no way of anything getting to you except for vultures. And yeah, let's skip to horde night. Let me show you guys how this goes. So it's finally horde night. Zombies will start dropping in shortly. I put it on 64 horde. So yeah, it's a huge horde night. And as you can see, guys, they're dropping down. They're going to drop straight on our building and just wrecked all the way down to the ground. Now what's going to happen, guys? They're going to stack up on top of each other, especially on a 64 zombie horde. But even if they reach your build, they're not going to be able to damage it. They're just going to stand there for you to shoot them. I'll show you later on in this video. And as you can see, it's just raining zombies and they can't do anything. They're going to be stuck down there. Not knowing what to do, the AI will be completely broken. They can't hit a solid wall because it can't take damage. They can't ramp out to you, destroy any blocks to get to you. So they'll just be standing here stacking up on top of each other. It's very, very OP, guys. It's only me that knows about this. I'm sharing it with all of you guys so that it can eventually get patched. And that you want to use it, can use it as you want. It's very, very fun, very, very OP. And yeah, it's basically god mode. So I'm just gonna skip in a little bit to where the zombies finally start stacking up. Okay, so they're finally stacking up, guys. It's all 64 zombies down here. They're almost reaching me, but now you can just sit here with your sniper or M16, whatever weapon you have at your disposal, and you can just shoot the shit out of them. They're just gonna sit here like ducks for you to shoot. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. Please give some support by hitting that like button and by subscribing. It really helps my channel to grow. And yeah, I'm glad I could have shared this new OP glitch exploit with you guys. Till next time, guys. See ya.